forest, similar to the bushes in front of you, it's very dense. It's quite difficult for us people to get in there and actually look at them and study them, which means we don't see them too often. So it's quite cool that you can see them here at the zoo today. Now, start off on a little bit of a conservation note about our bush dogs, because they are a near threatened species, which means their numbers are on decline. Now, especially because we can't really get into their natural habitat to see them very well, the reasons for this aren't quite as well understood as for some other animals. But we do know that habitat loss is a big issue for these guys, just like many of the other rainforest animals. The large areas of their home are being chopped down to make things out of the wood, so that's things like paper items, which we all use here. So don't feel bad if you do use paper items. I hope you all use kitchen roll and toilet roll at least on a daily basis. Because what you can do is you can look out for the FSC symbol. It's like a big tree that turns into a tip, and any of your paper that has this symbol on it has been sourced sustainably, which means we've left enough of the rainforest for these guys to live in and taken just enough for ourselves. So it's a really easy thing that we can do. So grown-ups, keep your eyes peeled. Kids, your job is to look out for that and tell your grown-ups what to do when they are buying their paper items. And we can really make a difference for them, just from the UK, even though they're a long way from South America. Now, bush dogs are fantastic little creatures. We're very lucky to have 8 of the bush dogs here at the zoo. And we have an alpha male and female named Vast and Japora. And in fact, Vast is the one that's in front of you here. He's got a lovely little grey patch on his neck, so he's quite easy to spot. Japora is our chunkier girl, although I can't see her at the minute. And the other 6 are actually their babies. So we have a lovely big family group here at the zoo. And in fact, out in the wild, this is similar to how they would live. They live in groups of about 12 to 16, and it's only the alpha male and female that have the pups. So even though other animals from different groups might live in the same group, they all work really hard to look after those pups. So the females of the group are quite sneaky when it comes to babies, because once they have had those babies and they have established themselves as top dog, pun intended, they will produce a hormone which stops any of the other females actually having babies. So she sort of tricks them a little bit into looking after her own. But even though others might not be the parents to those pups, they go out of their way to help feed them, protect them, not even put themselves in danger to look after those pups. So they work quite well as a little social family group. So I'm going to come on to a little bit of a strange fact about our bush dogs now, to do with their paws. How many of you here have got a pet dog at home? Okay, a couple of you. So have you ever seen them swimming? Especially in weather like this, I'm sure all of you have seen a dog paddling. They look a little bit silly, don't they? So these guys are related to the dogs that we have at home, but you won't see them paddling quite as clumsily as your beloved pets, because they are semi-aquatic, which means they spend quite a lot of their time in the water. If you look really closely at their paws, you'll see that their paws are webbed. So if you hold your fingers up, you will see that we've got 5 separate things that stick out. They are our fingers. If we have webbed hands, we have pieces of skin that go from the top, so that when we go like this, we have a nice big area to push water with, which is what our little bush dogs have. Which means it's really easy for them to swim quite well, and especially being in the Amazon basin, where there's lots of fresh floods and quite a lot of rivers, it's really useful for them to be able to get out of danger and also swim around their environment. But they also use this very well when it comes to looking for their food. But since they're coming onto their food now, I will make a start of throwing it in, because they're looking at you very longingly, and I feel bad for keeping them waiting. So when they are hunting, they will use their water. Let me put the chicken in, and then I'll start my sentence. They will use their fantastic swimming to their advantage. So half of the bush dogs will wait in the water or near the water, and the other half of the bush dogs will chase their prey towards it. Now the prey that they eat isn't going to be quite as good at swimming as these guys, so they trick them to go near the water, and then the rest of the bush dogs will ambush them. So they work really well together to catch that fish. So they are eating chicken now, which is quite a small food. Themselves, they would eat them similar size. There's an animal called an abeti, which looks a little bit like a shrew, but it's about this big, so a little bit bigger, and they would take down that sort of prey on their own. But when they get together, they are able to take down things as big as a cat Capybara, which is about this big. So it's the world's largest rodent, absolutely enormous, easily 4 times the size of these guys. And even rheas, which are like small ostriches. So there's no need to be put off by their small size. They are in fact very mighty. Now I can't quite see where we've gone, so I won't keep you for too much longer if not everybody's had a good view. We're going to finish up with a quick sort of little quiz for you guys. So these guys have a nickname. And the nickname that they have is in Spanish, because they speak Spanish in South America where they come from. And the reason they have this nickname is because of what they smell like. So I'm going to say 3 things, and you just put your hand up when you think that's what they smell like, okay? So who thinks that they smell like wet dog? No one? They are swimming dogs? Okay, you might think it's a purple. Who thinks they smell like vinegar? Okay, a couple of people. And who thinks they smell like cake? Well, nobody got it wrong. Everybody got it right. They do in fact smell like vinegar. And their nickname is Cochero Vinagre, which translates to vinegar dog. Now the reason they smell like vinegar is because they actually scent mark their territory. So you might see some of the females jumping up at trees, a little bit like cats on their scratching posts, and putting their scent on those trees to let other bush dogs know that this is their territory and they don't want anyone to mess that up. What you need to do is just the way that they actually make these scent marks. If you ever wanted to get so close to them, you need to look out for those red feet and you might notice that vinegar smell. So I think I've timed that perfectly because I've just seen the last bomb go into a burrow over there. If any of you have any questions, please feel free to come and ask me. I'll do my best to answer them. If you'd like another talk, we'll be doing the Holland Road in about 20 minutes time, just over behind the Wet n Wild play area. But if not, enjoy the rest of your day at the zoo. Thank you. Thank you.